Well, time now to hear from another person who's not been able to yet get back to the Isle of Man. They've filled in their forms, been processed. And Mark's joining us now from the UK. Mark, who is a Manx guy as such, Manx resident, but has been off the Isle of Man more than 6 months. And I say that because that's all important, Mark, to your story. And it is quite a situation. I know it's distressed you quite a bit and your family. You were meant to be back now. So take us through what's gone wrong.
I completed all the forms. I have been off the island for over 6 months. I completed all the forms online, answered all the questions, which indicated that I had been off the island for 6 months or longer. They asked me what residency rights I had, and they gave me a list of things that I could prove. One of them was Manx National Insurance number, which I gave. So I got all my documents on the 17th of April, giving me my notice to travel on the 22nd. I then phoned the travel team on Saturday morning. I paid my money to the travel team. I arranged a lift from Hertfordshire up to Heysham, so that was all in place. On Tuesday the 21st, I said goodbye to my boss. I'd walked out of his employment, and I'd given up my room. At quarter past five that evening, so this is Tuesday evening now, on quarter past five, I got an email withdrawing my right to travel because I hadn't been resident for 6 months on the island. I never hid behind that. I said I hadn't been resident for 6 months. So I had a few phone calls backwards and forwards, lots of apologies, but didn't actually help. And then I suppose on the Wednesday lunchtime now, the day I was meant to be travelling, I got a call from a guy at Heysham Port asking me where I was, because he hadn't been informed that I wasn't travelling. He was
So you had a space on that boat? I mean, you took one of those slots?
Yes. Yeah. And I'd paid all my money, and it ended up that he'd been told by another passenger who knew of me that I wasn't travelling, and he needed to confirm it. And he said to me, "Mark, I'm ever so sorry to tell you this." He said, "But had you arrived at the boat, we would have screened you, and if you'd have passed the screening, you'd have been on that boat and you'd have sailed."
And you'd paid your money, had you? You said.
I'd paid my money at that point to the travel team with the COMIS. Yes.
This is what, the 875.
£875 I paid.
And it didn't get worse, because I think the hotel said they were expecting you, weren't they?
Yeah, I phoned them up and they had no idea. They had dinner ready, apparently. They had no idea that I wasn't coming.
So
they had to then go away and make phone calls and confirm that I actually wasn't arriving.
Something's gone wrong, horribly wrong here, because you had told them the truth and you had got confirmation that you were on the system. So
what can
you do now? I mean, you got your money back, have you, I trust?
I've got my money back now, yes. COMIS had to make a couple of phone calls just to confirm I wasn't arriving. And yes, I got my money back. So there's no problem there. As far as what I can do now, at the moment, I've had countless emails back from various people in the Isle of Man government, including the Chief Minister himself, all sort of saying, "We're really, really sorry, but hard lines, that's the rules."
Oh, so you're not now eligible to come back?
No, currently no. I mean, I still try every opportunity to try and get through to somebody. And like I say, all the people that I've spoken to in the Isle of Man government, while they've all been extremely apologetic and extremely helpful and everything else, it hasn't changed anything. I'm still here.
And and you're jobless and you homeless, if that sounds like, well, not, you know, you gave up all this thing to move back.
Well, yeah, I mean, at the moment, an ex-colleague of mine has kindly offered me a room for the time being, at least. From a job point of view, my replacement started a couple of weeks ago. Now, we are key workers, so I work for a mechanic. We are key workers because we're keeping delivery vehicles and such like on the road. So I've been able to go him. I'm the workshop manager there, and I'm now going in on a voluntary basis to keep my own sanity more than anything else, training my replacement.
Okay.
So because there's no way I know he can't afford both wages. I know that because I've seen what's coming in and what's going out, and we're keeping open for the people that need us.
So if there's another slot that comes up, if you know from this interview, maybe someone does work out they can do something, you still want to come back, obviously.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I've seen a spreadsheet tonight, which has been provided by somebody who's, you obviously know about the Facebook group for the COMIS hotel that they've created. And they've sent out a sort of a shot to everybody who's stranded and saying, "What are you doing?" And of the 54 people, I think, that have been polled, 5 want to come back when the borders open. 40 odd want to come back when they can go home and self-isolate. And the other 5, which includes me, will come back under any circumstance possible. So there's 5 people that would happily take that slot and go to the comb. I say happily. They want to come back that much that they would take that offer if that was made.
And just to beat the people who are going to have a go at you because you haven't got back in time, you couldn't come any earlier?
No, I couldn't come any earlier. I had things that I had to tie up here. Personal reasons, I had things that I needed to do here for myself. And then the other reason for coming back is that my dad is a key worker on the island. My stepmother, his wife, has got multiple sclerosis, currently not working in quite a bad way. So my dad has got a house in Peel, three-story Victorian house with a self-contained flat in the middle. That's where I was going, and I was going to be able to offer some support to them as well. So apart from my own personal reasons for coming back, I could also support my family when I got back as well.
Do you think
I couldn't have got back any earlier?
Yeah. Do you think there is another opportunity here? I mean, what can you do? You've written all your letters, and you haven't had any response that you wanted, I suppose. Is that right?
No. I've not had any response I wanted. At the minute, I'm sort of, for my own sanity now, I'm having to say, look, you know, stop chasing it, and just, you're going to have to suck it up and wait for the borders to open. I mean, of course, if somebody does come along and say, yes, Mark, you can come back, I'm going to be there like a shot. I mean, like I say, from a work point of view, we're doing everything that we can to keep ourselves safe. You know, we have vehicles in, they're sanitized, we're working behind closed doors. So we're doing everything that we can to make sure that we stay away from this virus. And so far, touch wood, reasonably successful with that, you know. And I don't think anybody that wants to come back to the island is coming back with the idea of, oh, yes, we're all going to come back and we're all going to go for a walk around the streets. You know, we all know if we come home, we have to self-isolate. I mean, I know there's one person who I've seen a Facebook post today of a key worker that's coming over to the island to live on Thursday. Now, I'm not knocking the key worker at all. Absolutely not. But they're coming over to live on Thursday. They're not even a Manx resident. But because they're deemed a key worker, they can come and live. And I can't see how they're treating a key worker who's not a resident of the Isle of Man, allowing them to come back, not go to the Comish Hotel, go and self-isolate. Obviously, they've been told there's harsh penalties around it if they don't, and I've seen that. So I know that they, you know, they're sort of saying we're going to do the right thing by the Isle of Man, but they're treating key workers that are not from the island vastly differently to the people that want to get back to the island.